Necessity becomes the mother of invention. And I think in Africa, the reason you see things like M-Pesa and you know, mobile currency is not because we're just innovative, it's because we're forced to be. It's very, very interesting the way banks are being attacked. I think in the banking industry, people have used terms like death by a thousand wounds. Everyone's going after the store of value. And I think what we see happening in the world right now are business model shifts. People are moving their business models away from advertising, which was kind of the Google way of making money, into the world of transaction enablement, where the store of value becomes the focal point. And I think if you take a look at the telecommunications environment, where data revenue is on a decline, voice revenue has been on a decline, the telecommunications companies are now focusing on transaction enablement. You know, you look at the over-the-top players like Google and Facebook, and you take a look at what they're doing in payment. Now you find Apple's there. And it's very, very interesting because people are asking the question, where do the banks fit in with all of this? And I think what we've done too long is underestimate the role of banks. And undervalued their position and why they do exist. And I think the role for banks moving forward is not disintermediation. I think the roles for bank moving forward is a great opportunity that is presented by technology. I think Africa is on the leading edge of payment because it is not a fun thing. It's a very real business challenge, a lifestyle challenge. You know, when payment doesn't work in Africa, people die. And the reason I started the company Thumbs Up is because I had an experience where a lady couldn't make a payment and she lost one of her twins because they switched off her utilities in the middle of winter, even though she had a card and she had money. And they switched off her utilities and one of her kids died of exposure. So the services that we are working on, the innovation that we are busy dealing with, we got to take a step back in the financial services industry and realize it's not just innovation for innovation's sake. If we get this right, we save lives. If we get it wrong, we fundamentally negatively change people's lives. And in Africa, we've got massive challenges. Just ask the question differently. I've had this question thrown at me. Do you think, because of all the connectivity in Africa, that the next Facebook will come from Africa? Do you think the next Twitter will come from Africa? Do you think the next Yahoo? I don't think so. I think what you'll see is the next Yahoo of water purification. I think you'll see the next Google of healthcare. I think you'll see the next Twitter of agriculture. In Africa, we are dealing with things on a human level. We are dealing with challenges that are very serious hurdles for humanity. And we are trying to overcome that with some of the technology. So I think necessity becomes the mother of invention. And I think in Africa, the reason you see things like M-Pesa mobile currency is not because we're just innovative, it's because we're forced to be, because of the lifestyle that we have there, because of the lack of bank penetration, bank branch penetration, and the challenges that a day-to-day African has to deal with. And lo and behold, if we can solve those problems in Africa, suddenly we have global applicability from a marketplace perspective. And I think a lot of entrepreneurs like myself in Africa are starting to realize this, that if we can make something like this thing work in South Africa, considering the lack of connectivity, considering the literacy rates that are so low, considering the smartphone penetration not being as high, if we can be successful with something like this over there, then the world's our oyster. We've built a product called the Payment Pebble that will be called FastPay Card Reader. And it is essentially a card reading device that plugs into a mobile phone that enables card present payment inside of the ANZ FastPay app. So this is the little device that we built in South Africa. We call it the Payment Pebble. Over here, they're gonna be calling it the Fast Card Reader. And essentially what you'll be able to do is, you'll be able to launch FastPay. And instead of putting in the card credentials of someone, you'll be able to plug in the FastPay reader, and it'll allow you to accept Chip and PIN, Mag and PIN credit cards. So if you take a look at your small and medium businesses, you take a look at your enterprises struggling with payment collection, this little device solves that problem. And it's extremely simple. You plug it into the phone and it converts it to a card acceptance machine. And you're good to go. So we've launched this partnership with ANZ in Australia. And we're very, very excited about taking this to market over here locally.